It was never about the money. I was better. I was supposed to be better. It was never about the money.
What the hell are you to tell me I can't have this, huh?
Do you have a permit for that?
Of course I have a permit. Get the hell out of my office. I said get out of my office. Raskolnikov, your rent's overdue. When are you gonna pay it?
Yeah, I'll be getting some money soon, alright?
Yeah, that's what you always say.
Down. I just came to see if you were all right.
A student?
Why?
A student then. Or formerly a student. Just as I thought. I am a man of experience. Immense experience, sir.
Why were you crying?
Drunkenness is not a virtue. No, sir. But beggary, honored, sir. Beggary is a vice. In poverty, you may still retain your innate nobility of soul. But beggary? Never.
What a queer fellow.
5 nights I've slept in this field.
5 nights?
For fear of home, sir. In a fit of drunkenness, I have lost my job and the money that my family has depended on. My very own daughter has been forced to prostitute herself. Drunkenness is not a virtue, no, sir. But beggary. My heart aches to think what a useless worm I am. I'm not even capable of beggary. What non-existent honor I have left won't allow me. What little money that has been left has gone towards this.
Your wife? What does she think about all this?
Katerina Ivanovna, my spouse. She is a woman of noble heart. I realize that when she pulls my hair, she only does it out of pity. For I repeat, without being ashamed. She pulls my hair, young man. Do you know I sold her stockings for a drink? Not her shoes, no. That would have been more or less in the order of things. But her stockings. Her stockings for a drink. What a useless fool am I. A useless man. Goodbye, sir. Now I must go to face my fate.
Oh, the letter. Mother. My dear Rodia. It's been 2 months since I last had a talk with you by letter, which has distressed me and even kept me awake at night.
Thinking. You know how I love you. You're all we have to look to, your sister Dunya and I. What a grief it was to me when I heard that you had given up the university some months ago for reasons which you've kept to yourself. And that you had lost your lessons and other work. I did not write you because your sister and I felt it would be unnecessary to burden you with such heavy news. The situation with Dunya and her employer has been resolved, however. But there is other news as well. Pyotr Petrovich Lusin has asked for Dunya's hand in marriage. He is already of the rank of a counselor and is altogether a very respectable and presentable man. Only he seems a little morose and conceited. This is probably only from a first impression, however. Dunya has with much thought accepted his proposal. I apologize for this to occur without your consent, but I'm sure you won't have an issue. Dunya plans to ask him to perhaps make you his business partner, and then you won't have to worry about money anymore. Your sister and I might be able to visit you soon. We are coming with Pyotr. We will have to borrow some money for it, but do not worry, we will travel third class to save money. But enough, I have covered 2 sheets already and there is no space left for more. And now, my precious Rodia, I embrace you and send you a mother's blessing till we meet. Yours truly, Mother.
No, you cannot deceive me. I see this man for who he is and I despise him already. He seemed conceited at first sight, but no doubt he is a gentleman. Ha! What kind of man will allow his bride-to-be and his mother travel in third class while he travels in luxury?
In this business deal,
he must surely be a good businessman, seeing as how he cannot even afford to help his fiancée. This is ridiculous! I will not allow my sister to marry this vile man!
My head was heavy, my thoughts were muddled, but I continued to torture myself with these questions, finding a sort of enjoyment in it. But this was nothing compared to the torment that I had been putting myself through for the last few weeks as I had attempted to plot out what I was going to do. I should have known.
Who is it?
Kid, I'm sick and tired of trying to ask for your money every day, alright?
Hey, I'll get your money, right? Just give me some time.
You've got till the end of this month, or else
I'm- else what?
Or else I'm kicking your ass out of here in 3 days!
Jesus!
God.